सत्या, हाउ शुड आई डू क्वेश्चन नंबर वन?
So we have to do 47.5 upon 40 into 100. So it is equal to 118.75%.
Okay. See, there are two ways in which you can do the question, and you can use either of them. See, one way is that he had bought 10 notebooks for rupees 40. So cost price of one notebook would be rupees 4. Satya, is it correct?
Yes, sir.
And the selling price of one notebook is 4.75. Is it correct? Satya, is it correct?
Yes, sir.
So the profit is 4.75 minus 4 is equal to 0.75. Satya, is it correct?
Yes, sir.
So his profit percentage would be 0.75 upon cost price into 100. Sarthak, have you understood this?
Yes, sir.
So the second way of doing the same question, you can see both the solutions are okay. Whatever you are comfortable with, you can use that method. The other method is that I have cost price of 10 notebook, which is equal to rupees 40. Then I find selling price of 10 notebook. That would be equal to 4.75 into 10, which will be equal to rupees 47.50. Satya, is it correct?
Yes.
Then I find the profit, which is 47.50 minus 40, which is 7.50. The profit percent would be 7.50 upon 40 into 100. Sarthak, have you understood the two methods?
Yes, sir.
Now, what I'm trying to tell you is that you can use this method also, you can use this method also, you will get the same answer. Have you understood, Mr. Sarthak?
Yes, sir.
Both this method and this method will give the same answer. If you want to try, just multiply the numerator and denominator here by 10. See what you will get. You will get 7.5 upon 40 into 100, which is the same as you have written here. Mr. Ariman, have you understood? Ariman, have you understood? Mr. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So basically what we have done is, you can find the profit per notebook. What I'm trying to tell you is, you can find the profit percentage per notebook. Per notebook means for one notebook. Or you can find the profit percentage for 40 notebooks. The answer would remain the same. Mr. Satya, have you understood?
Yes.
Sarthak, is there any confusion?
No, sir.
Vasharivan, is there any confusion?
Yeah.
Satya, were you able to do question number two?
Yes, sir, but I'm not sure about it.
Okay. How did you try it?
Sir, I did like three. I divided 3 by 4. So then I got an answer. So I multiplied it by 3.
See, first so we need to work. Yeah,
sir. So I divided 3 by 4, so I got 0.75. Then I did like he sells it for 3 for 4 rupees. So I multiplied it by 4. So my answer was 3.
See, he buys 4 oranges for rupees 3. So he has bought 1 orange for rupees 3 by 4. Is it correct? Satya, is it correct? Sir. Now he sells 3 oranges for rupees 4. Therefore, he has sold 1 orange for rupees 4 by 3. Is it correct, Mr. Satya?
Yes, sir.
So the CP is rupees 3 by 4. The SP is rupees 4 by 3. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So Sarthak, is there a profit or is there a loss?
Sir, there's profit.
There is a profit of 4 by 3 minus 3 by 4. So, Arvan, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So, I find the LCM. 3, 4, the 16. Minus 4, 3, the 9. So, this would be 7 by 12. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Again, it is one of the difficult questions. Maybe you'll have to see the video again to understand how to do such questions. It's a bit difficult question. Now, this is the profit and the cost price is 3 by 4. So my profit percentage would be 7 by 12 divided by 3 upon 4. In 200. Mr. Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Sir, this is a difficult question. You may have to look at the video again. But it would be better if you try to do this question again. Sir, slightly difficult question. And then we need to calculate this. This would be 7 upon 12 into 4 upon 3 into 100. Satya, have you understood what I have done?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Sarthak, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Then we need to calculate this. 4, 3, the... So this would be 700 upon 9 percentage. Mr. Aryaman, have you understood?
Yeah.
What you should do is, you should actually try to do both these questions again if you haven't done it. Just try to do these questions again, good questions. And try to do this question, the first question, by both the methods. One method is when you find the cost price and selling price for one notebook. Just try to do this and verify. The other method is try to find the cost price and selling price for 10 notebooks and verify whether the profit percent, the gain percent is same or not. Satya, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So use both the methods. This method 1 also, method 2 also. Verify that the answer is same. And of course, you need to do question number 2 again. Because this is a slightly difficult question. So, Mr. Sarthak, any doubt?
No, sir.